I'm David Mould. Welcome to our website. Chances are you're here because you saw our print ad or heard a conversation about it or were emailed this link by a friend. This ad has introduced most of you to a book you'd never heard of before, General Thomas Harris's Assassination of Lincoln. General Harris was one of the 9 men who sat on the military tribunal that heard all the evidence in the assassination plot. His narrative provides a magnificent window into the drama. In his book, General Harris introduces us to each of the known conspirators. 1, Mary Surratt, whom it is said kept the nest that hatched the egg. Lewis Powell, who was busy trying to kill Secretary of State Seward, even as President Lincoln was being assassinated. George Atzerodt, who had been assigned to kill Vice President Johnson, but who got drunk and lost his nerve. Edmund Spangler, the Ford's Theater employee who kept the horses used in the escape. Dr. Samuel Mudd, who set Booth's leg and aided in his escape. Michael O'Loughlin and Samuel Arnold, who had been involved in earlier attempts to kidnap President Lincoln. And then there are the 3 on the wanted poster. John Wilkes Booth, David Herold, and Mary Surratt's son, John. Of the 10, 4, including Mary Surratt, the first woman executed by the federal government, were hung. 4 were sent to prison, 1 was shot and killed, and 1 escaped. Here's what we know about the 3 on the wanted poster. After shooting President Lincoln on the night of April 14, 1865, Booth jumped out of the presidential box at Ford's Theater in full view of the shocked audience. On the way down the 9 feet to the stage, his spurs caught in a curtain, causing him to fall and break his leg. Though severely handicapped, he managed to escape on horseback with his accomplice, David Herold, into the night and across the Potomac with flame. When cornered by a detachment of Union troops in Port Royal, Virginia on April 26th, Herold gave up. Ever defiant, Booth chose to fight and was shot and killed. While Booth and Herold were fleeing, the 3rd man on the wanted poster, John Surratt, who also was at Ford's Theater on the night of the 14th, was escaping by a different route. What do we know about Surratt? At the outbreak of the Civil War, he had abandoned his studies for the priesthood at St. Charles College in Maryland and entered the Confederate service as a courier and sometimes spy. It is thought that after Lincoln was shot, he made his way by train to Burlington, Vermont, and from Burlington took a ferry over to Montreal. What we do know is that in Montreal, he was ultimately put into the care of 2 Roman Catholic priests, Father Boucher and Father Lapierre, who effectively hid him for 5 months. When he finally emerged, well disguised, I should add, he was put on board a steamer, the Peruvian, bound for Liverpool. There he would be sheltered in the oratory of the Church of the Holy Cross, an accommodation frequently used by American Catholics visiting Liverpool. When the State Department finally tracked him down over a year later, he was caught in the papal Zouaves, part of the army of Pope Pius IX. Surratt would escape, some say was allowed to escape, but was caught again, this time in Alexandria, Egypt. Now, I have a question to put to you. How come America has never heard this, most of America? How come high school students don't know this? Why has this information been kept from generations of Americans? I'd like to change this by doing 3 things. 1, reprinting this book by the millions. 2, producing an in-depth documentary on President Lincoln's assassination. 3, running a major media campaign about both. It's not politically correct video, it's history. Inconvenient history, perhaps even unpleasant history, but history nonetheless. You'll be the richer for watching it.